Probably you may not know, but I'm one of the Fogarty alumni, and I trained in immunology at Case Western, and I did a two-year master's training, and I've continued with my training on-site here in Uganda. Since I came back, I think I spearheaded training of immunology, not only to clinicians, but also to biomedical scientists. The model we used at that time was good, in that we didn't have human resources at that time, so it was good to go and train in US Cleveland for my case, and then come back here. But I think over the years, with the human resource improving here on site, and people voicing a need to have more and more training in Uganda so they are not away from site for too long. When you are away on site, you kind of fall back in developing both socially and also in other areas as well. So the model people are now interested in is a kind of sandwich model, where one gets a Fogarty grant, where they do some of their training in Uganda, then they go to another university for, let's say, 3 to 6 months, gain some skills and come back. And at the end, get training that they can apply to the local scenario, but get the technical expertise they would need from other countries. So I would support continuing with the Fogarty program, especially in the areas of training people in biomedical sciences. We have a model of microbiology where Fogarty graduate came back, found a department that had very few staff, and now over the years he has built up labs, he has built up staff, and he has a cadre of students. We want to replicate the same for pathology, where we have a person who spearheads pathology growth here. Pathology, as you may be aware, is of interest to clinicians. We are the ones who use the services. I want a correct diagnosis for my leukemia lymphoma, not to misdiagnose it. So if we have people who are trained in molecular diagnosis, who are trained both there and here, so that they bring the technology that we can use here, try it out here, and use that as their training model. A system where they go out for 5 years to be trained, by the time they come back, they'll find Uganda doesn't have any of the machines they've been used to in the last 5 years. But if they know that, you know, this would be useful in Uganda, so they get that technology, start from scratch, and build it up to such a level that we can have a pathology services that is of benefit to our patients. Our patients need that. They are waiting for that. But thank you for coming.